YouTube, what is going on? My name is Rittain Kevin, whatever you want to call me, and this is NBA 2K13 Offensive Adjustments. These are small tweaks you can make on the offensive end to become a better player in 2K. Now, before we get into it, make sure you check out Defense Adjustments Part 1 and Part 2. This is Part 1 of my mini-series. In this series, I'm going to give you 5 tips that will make you a better player by your next game. Some tips you may know, but hopefully there will be something that you do not know or something you can adjust to make yourself a better player on the offensive end. Let's get to work. Running plays. Running plays is almost a requirement when playing on the higher difficulty levels or you lack a star player presence. Working the ball around, using off-the-ball picks, and other offensive schemes will enable you to get a good look at the rim. Remember, each play has several options. Here are a few examples of some plays and their options. LeBron has a pick at the top of the key by Chris Bosh. He rolls to the hole. That leaves Shane Battier wide open for three-pointer. Now, if you take a look here, on the screen and roll, there was a chance to make the pass. However, it was pretty risky. There's too many feet in the way. So I decided to go to Shane Battier at the top of the key. Rasheed Wallace was really late to close out, as always, and Shane Battier was able to hit the open jump shot. Shane Battier had another option to go to Chalmers on the right wing if he didn't have the jump shot. This is just isolation play for Carmelo. Takes his defender off the dribble, hops back, makes the open jump shot. All right, this play is a LeBron James off the baseline come through for a post-up play. Ball is passed to LeBron. He takes his quick spin move and throws it downward. Now, if you look here in detail, it looks like LeBron cleared space off Carmelo, posted up. He didn't have great position. He repositioned his body and then just to get the ball and spun quickly and threw it down. Advanced passing. Just like in all 2K games, you can use lead passing. When pressing the pass button, hold the stick in the position you want the player to go when receiving the pass. Use the bounce pass to get the ball in the hard to reach spots on the floor. Do not use it in traffic or throw it horizontal to the court. This will result in a turnover. Only use it when going towards the rim for a cutter or to the postman. Using the hop step. In 2K13, the hop step has changed greatly. You can just hop step towards the rim to complete a shot, or you can hop step away from the rim to draw space for your shooter. You can hop step to the right or to the left to get into your shooter's hot spot, or you can hop out of the post to make a turnaround jump shot. You can hop to get to a better position to make the pass. There's a lot of hopping you can do here. However, if you get hop crazy, or if you hop into the lane, you probably will get ripped. Signature skills. 2K this year implemented signature skills, and these are just essentially little cards that each player has that allows them to do certain skills better than other players. So for example, posterizer. Whenever they dunk on someone, their team are given a small energy boost, and they must have an energy level of 80 or higher. So things like this are actually really important to have on your team and actually fully understand. So let's go over a couple really quick just to get a good idea on how we should utilize these players. Alley-ooper, a player is known to throw alley-oops. So basically, if this player, when he throws an alley-oop, his attribute points go up 20 points higher for his passer rating, and also his air is reduced by 50%. So a player like Chris Paul has this attribute. He's able to throw alley-oops better than a player that does not have this attribute. Chase Down Artist is a player who's able to run down a player and block a shot. Now, any player can do it, but these players are actually given a speed boost, quickness, and vertical boost when chasing down a player from behind. JaMale McGee and LeBron James are the two players that I think, off the top of my head, that have this attribute. Hustle points. A player like Kevin Love, he actually has this right here. When he comes down the offensive rebound, you put the ball right back up, and you have an increase of points. You have an increased percentage of the shot going in off of offensive rebound. So when you get the rebound with one of these guys, put the ball right back up. Microwave, Jamal Crawford comes to mind. He's the type of player that gets hot, and he gets hot very, very quickly. Jamal Crawford, all it takes is a jump shot and 2 free throws, and he's actually on fire. My favorite combination is actually spot-up shooter, dead-eye, and corner specialist. Ray Allen has these attributes. So if he's in the corner, spot up, he's barely going to miss the shot. You need to set up a game plan and make sure he's not open in the corner. Finisher and acrobat, when these two combine, players like Russell Westbrook and Derrick Rose, these players are able to make a layup with contact while changing their shot. And this shot goes in a lot. And it's not to the point where it's unrealistic, but it's to the point where it's difficult to defend these guys. And just like real life, you know, when Derrick Rose goes to the lane, he'll change his shot, he'll take the contact, he'll take the foul, and he'll make the shot. So these attributes are some attributes you should look out for when you have your team to make sure you're using these players effectively. On the offensive end, it's important to tailor your game for your team. With a team like the Heat, when they run, it's important to get the ball off the fast break, take the ball into the paint, and see what happens. If you don't have an opportunity there, go ahead and bring the ball back out. In this example right here, I saw I had the mismatch on Paul Gasol. I was able to go right by Powell, and I saw Kobe down here in the lane. Knowing LeBron is a very good finisher, I tried my chances on Kobe, went up, changed my shot, got the foul, and won. In this example, off a missed shot, I kicked outlet pass to LeBron, went to the hole, didn't see anything at all, passed the ball back up top to Dwayne Wade, then he passed to Chalmers just to set the offense back up. Okay, so with the Lakers, we know they're an older team. They don't run as much. So when I get a rebound, I try to push the ball to Steve Nash, but there's nothing there, I back up. Miami Heat is way too fast for me to beat them down court. Take the ball back and restart my offense. YouTube Operation Sports, that is a wrap. This completes Offensive Adjustments Part 1. This is just going over some quick things that you can change in your next game that'll make you a better basketball player in NBA 2K13. Please rate, subscribe, go to my channel, comment, check my other videos out. I take a lot of time to make these videos. If you like them, then just let me know. That is it. Peace.